Hi, everybody, and welcome to a brand new Let's Pete. This is Chapter 3 in the Let's Pete Global Game Universe Takeover Saga that we're all going through together. Now, what game is it going to be? Well, so far the screen isn't offering any clues, but if you've read the title of this YouTube video, you may know already. I'm still going to announce it with a drum roll here. It's Star Wars. It's Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. But that takes way too long to say, so the cool kids have come up with a name for it. It's KOTOR. We're going to be playing KOTOR today. Now, you may not know this, but I am something of an old-time Star Wars fan myself. That's a video I made of myself in high school, using Photoshop. I have to come to terms with that every day. Now, in this game, we're going to have all the classic Star Wars staples that you know and love, such as the Force, Wookiees, space travel, and many more. It's going to satisfy everything a Star Wars fan could possibly want. And another big important factor of this game is the ability to make decisions and then face consequences for the decisions you make. So that's going to be conversation choices, quest paths, things like that. Now, I myself am no stranger to making bad decisions. I still think about that every day. So, come with me now, and let's try to make good decisions for once in Star Wars, Knights of the Old Republic. Alright, let's start a new game. Okay. So, the first thing you're going to have to do is create your character. Now, this is a role-playing game, meaning that, we can choose to be a few different roles here, and that's going to affect some of our stats, and that's also going to affect perhaps a few minor, text elements in the story. We're still going to generally have the same experience no matter what. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to cop out and pick the male soldier because he's better at fighting. And I'm not trying to have an extra super hard time and film that and have you watch me lose a bunch of battles. Yeah, so let's go ahead and do some customization on this guy. Now, it's very important to pick what he looks like, so unfortunately in KOTOR I don't think you can make a good-looking character, but let's see who I can make here. I love how when you pick them, they kind of go, huh, with the eyebrow? They give you the people's eyebrow. I can't do that. Okay, less talking, more focusing. Ugh, this guy. Would anyone forgive me if I picked this guy? He has, like, the hair I wish I had. Oh god, these decisions are awful. Because you know what? We're going to have to stare at this dude the whole rest of the game. You know, I'll pick the one that kind of has, like, the hair most similar to me, perhaps, and you'll have to forgive me. Okay, so attributes. Let's see. Now, I think... So I'm not a D&D player, I've played one time. I think this uses the D&D rules or math or something for attributes, so if you're familiar with that, this will probably make a lot of sense. I'm just going to treat it like any other game. And, you know, you've got... Okay, strength means you do more damage, stuff like that. Dexterity, that's going to be better accuracy. Health... Intelligence is going to give you more skills. Wisdom is going to add modifiers to force powers. And charisma is going to help us persuade people and do some other force things too. So let's just go ahead and start off by giving ourselves some well-rounded base here for this character. I don't want to be missing out on anything too bad. And then I'm gonna give him, let's do another one to strength, another one to constitution, another one to wisdom, and another one to charisma, and then maybe one more to charisma, and one more to wisdom. Now, if you're good at this game, you're probably screaming at me through the TV saying, oh my god, why would you make a character this way? Well, let's do it. Skills! So skills, these are going to be things that we can do in the game. We might be using some computers. We might be doing some demolition with some bombs or mines or something like that. We might be going into stealth mode. We're never going to go into stealth mode. Awareness is the ability to see things around you. So I know that works for mines that are hidden. Persuasion, super important to unlock some options in dialogue that can let us, be persuasive. Repair, it's going to be used to fix robots, obviously, for cheaper, I guess. Security, can we hack doors? All doors, you can literally punch doors open, so we're not going to worry about that too much. And treat injury, when you use a health potion or a medical med pack, as they're called in this game, how much does it heal you? So, in this case, what I want to do is... Oh, some of these actually cost 2, so this is nuts. Okay, so I definitely want persuade, treat injury to start us off. I'm gonna actually do a, let's do awareness, and let's do a security, and let's do a, computer use is for hacking, yeah. So, we're gonna have the opportunity to get some other characters that are gonna be a lot better at this stuff than we are. At the moment, I'm just going to give us a couple of skills like that so we have them. I'm actually not going to do security, I'm going to do repair. So we'll be able to do those actions, and we'll be very bad at them. That's kind of how I do my Let's Plays. Feats, okay. I promise this is not going to be quite so stat-heavy in future videos, but we're making our guy. This is our guy. Armor proficiency, so... He's going to automatically, because I picked the soldier, he's going to be good at, he can wear up to heavy armor, light armor, medium armor. He's going to start with power attack and power blast. He's got proficiency in pistols, rifles, heavy weapons, and melee weapons. So this guy's a fighter. You'd have a few different things if you picked a different character. So right off the bat, we've got a feat remaining. I don't exactly know what I'm going to do here with all of these things. So we can give +1 to demolitions and stealth. There's literally no chance we're going to ever do that. This is called caution. Do you think I'm going to play this game cautiously? Come on, you know me by now. You saw how I played Pikmin. Remember how many Pikmin we lost? Ugh, I'm still not over it. Let's see, what else do we have here? So critical strike, now that's going to be an attack. Empathy, so persuade, awareness, and treat injury. I kind of like that. I could be an empathetic fighter. Let's see, what else do we got here? Flurry, that's going to be an attack we can use. Gearhead, that's going to give us repair, security, and computer use. Not bad. It's kind of nice if we didn't have a lot of skill points. We can get some bonuses that way. Conditioning provides a +1 bonus to all saving throws. So I think a saving throw just means that when the game decides if somebody is going to, like, hit me with an attack or hit me with a critical, I have a chance to kind of like, no you didn't, and it's going to give me some more of that no you didn't kind of thing. And if you're into D&D, you're probably screaming at the monitor saying, God, this guy's awful, he's lying to his audience. And it's more ignorance, it's less malicious lying, so don't worry about that. Implants, that's a type of equipment we can get, gives us bonuses, so when we find some cool equipment, some cool implants, maybe I'll get one of those. Power attack, we got that already. Rapid shot, if we're going to be using blasters, we might want to do that. You can become a further master of these weapons, which looks like it just gives you extra damage. Toughness, yeah. Gives an extra vitality point every time they level up. Right? Oh, yeah. And it's retroactive, that's good to know. And then level 2, wow, subtracts... damage, and then... Oh, okay, so we're going to get into that later. That'll be fun. Dueling, if you just want to use one weapon. So I could have dual pistols, or I could have one pistol. Dueling is if you want to use one weapon, so we'll get around to that. So I'll tell you what I'm going to do. Right now, I'm going to grab the other attack that we didn't get. That's going to be Flurry. Oops, add feet. I am playing this on the Nintendo Switch, so certainly not what this came out on, but we'll see what we can do. So accept, name. Uh-oh. What's a very, like, Star Wars-y name? Besides Pete. Okay, change of plans. I want a very Star Wars-y name, so we're gonna go with Pete Spaceman. Not Spaceman. You're saying it wrong. Spaceman. Pete Spaceman, because Star Wars takes place in outer space. That's kind of its deal. Alright, and then the next step in our character creation is, heck, let's play the game. So we're definitely pretty well balanced right now. I hope that's a strategic way to go here. That's how I usually like to make characters in games, so let's see what happens. We'll play for a little bit and then we'll take a break. Knights of the Old Republic. 4,000 years before the rise of the Galactic Empire, the Republic verges on collapse, aren't they always? Darth Malak, the last surviving apprentice of the Dark Lord Revan, has unleashed an invincible Sith armada upon an unsuspecting galaxy. Crushing all resistance, Malak's war of conquest has left the Jedi Order scattered and vulnerable as countless knights fall in battle. And many more swear allegiance to the new Sith Master. Oof. That's no good. In the skies above the outer rim world of Taris, a Jedi battle fleet engages the forces of Darth Malak in a desperate effort to halt the Sith's galactic domination. Okay, so we're in orbit above Taris, and we're fighting Darth Malak's fleet. That is very hard to read on camera. The Star Wars scroll. Oh my god. Oh, classic John Williams. You gotta love the music, right? Alright, that must be Taris. It's very Star Wars-y already. I love this. Oh, what is that? That's probably the ship around right now. Uh-oh. It's seen better days, that's for sure. Ugh, I don't want to be on this thing. Oh, we're going down. This is bad. Oh, we're just sinking here. We're going right towards that planet. Hope there's no valuable real estate on that planet. Ah, it was all a dream. Nothing's wrong at all. What the heck? I am Pete Spaceman. It's real. That's me.
By a Sith battle fleet. The Endar Spire is under attack. Hurry up, we don't have much time.
Okay, we're on the Endar Spire, that's our ship. There's really no time to talk about it, but that's okay. We're losing altitude. Look at the stars in the background, that's just crazy. Okay, so thank God this game's voice acted, so you don't have to hear me do all the voices. I'm gonna not go through all the superfluous dialogue options. Instead, I'm gonna get kind of to the point, and then maybe I'll just fill in some flavor text for you. Who are you, guy?
I'm Trask Ulgo, ensign with the Republic Fleet. I'm your bunkmate here on the Endar Spire. We work opposite shifts. I guess that's why you haven't seen me before. Now hurry up! We have to find Bastila. We have to make sure she makes it off the ship alive!
Yeah, everyone knows who Trask Ulgo is, the bunkmate in Star Wars. Totally a famous character. Who's Bastila, though?
Bastila is the commanding officer on the Endar Spire. Well, not an officer, really. But she's the one in charge of this mission. One of our primary duties is to guarantee her survival in the event of an enemy attack. You swore an oath just like everyone else on this mission. Now it's time to make good on that oath. I've heard all about your reputation. Elite combat training, tops in your class. It's no wonder you were handpicked for this mission. Word is, the officers haven't seen a recruit with your kind of potential in 20 years. But all that potential doesn't mean a thing if you can't deliver when it counts. We're soldiers. We're trained for combat. Bastila is going to need men and women like us at her side during this attack.
Yeah, that's fair. So there's definitely a lot of different texts there, right? Like, you can be the scoundrel, and he's like, oh, we caught you doing criminal activity, so now's your time to prove yourself or whatever. So we're the highly trained soldiers, so that's what we get. Oath or no oath, I'm heading to the escape pods. So, you know, like I said, a big part of this game is you can be nice or you can be, like, the meanest, most horrible jackass of the century. So, I'm gonna generally be good for the most part, but, I might be a little sassy, too. So, for now, yeah, let's help Master.
Hurry up and grab your gear. You need to suit up so we can get out of here.
Yeah, let me at least get my clothes on, guy. Alright. So let's just look around this room for a minute. Just for fun. You know what I'm also going to do, too? I'm going to just check the, this is our menu. Okay, super quick overview of the menu since I'm here. This is where you put on equipment. We don't have anything just yet. Inventory, what are we holding on to? There's Pete Spaceman. Look at his chiseled body. Okay, we don't need to go that far. Yep, here's all our stats and stuff. Boring. here's the text we just heard. The quests. The map. And options. I'm gonna just quick go into graphics and sound here. Okay, so this is good. I turned the music down a little bit. You know, Star Wars, right? So the music's gonna get real insane and probably be hard to talk over and hear people over, so I turned that down a little bit. You know what I might do, too, is I might just turn sound effects down slightly, and really what I want to do is just make sure you can always hear the voices. It's probably pretty good, though. You know what? Let's go ahead and save, too. Let's make a brand new save. That's my test character. He's gone. Alright. Yep. So, this is, you know, chairs of the future in Star Wars. You know, super comfortable. Nothing ever really looks comfortable in Star Wars. Look at this couch. Oh my god, he's still yelling at me. Yep, I know. I'll get to it. I'm looking at your furniture here. What's the point in saving Bastila if she can't relax? Look at this couch. It's horrible. Also, since this is a Let's Pete, I'm going to call out 3D things. So, yeah, you can see this really little normal map shading area there on the right side of that wall. You know, they put some 3D areas in the first room of the game just so I have something to comment on. Okay, Trask, I hear you. Let's go ahead and open up this footlocker. What's in here? Okay, we got adrenal stamina, a blaster rifle, a short sword, clothing, and 2 med packs. All that stuff was in there. Let's do it. Now, funny enough, I can actually add things to this. I could, like, leave my own items in here if I wanted to, but why would you do that? Alright, let's put some new equipment on. What did we get? Put some clothes on this guy. What else? Should we be a sword fighter, or should we use a blaster rifle? I'm gonna use a rifle, and then we'll see. Later on, I might switch it up. We'll see how this goes. Alright, I got my clothes, buddy.
Okay, let's move out. We should stick together. You'll have more success with a party than on your own.
Well, that's good life advice. Alright, Trask. We have the famous Trask Ulgo, and, ooh, what else is going on here? Who else are we going to meet? Very interesting. All we need is Trask. Forget these other characters.
This room is in lockdown, but don't worry. I've got the override codes.
Okay. So, he's locked us into the bedroom. Great start to the game, Trask. I cannot open the door. It says you'll need the access code. So, luckily, since we have a party, let me figure out the buttons. I can switch to Trask.
What?
And I can also switch back to Pete Spaceman. So Trask, now when he goes up to the door, he's got this option that says open, which we just tried. Doesn't work.
Now that the door is open, you better take the lead again.
Okay, it does work. It works because he has the codes, because that's the story so far. Alright, we got 100 experience, so let's go ahead and walk out into the next room here.
This is Cardinal Nassi. The Sith are threatening to overrun our position. We can't hold out long against their firepower. All hands to the bridge!
That was Karth contacting us on our portable communicators. He's one of the Republic's best pilots. He's seen more combat than the rest of the Endar Spire's crew put together. If he says things are bad, you better believe it. We have to get to the bridge to help defend Bastila. There's a map of the Endar Spire and a copy of Karth's message in your electronic journal, just in case we get separated.
Yeah, use your e-journal to see what Karth just said. Karth Onassi? Now that's a space name for sure. I wonder if he's going to be important to the story or not. I doubt he's going to be more important than Trask Ulgo. Alright, you know, I respect this little droid's commitment here to fixing up the ship. I mean, there's a lot of disarray, but, you know, do what you can. Alright, I'm sure things are fine out here. Let's head out.
That door is locked. I don't have the codes to open it. Switch me to the party leader so you can use my security skills to slice into the access panel and open the door.
Oh, okay, so he's gonna hack this door. So this one he doesn't know the codes for, but he can brute force it. So, security. Here we go. There's already some Star Wars action happening. Who are these guys? Murder! We've witnessed our first murder.
For the Republic!
Yes, for the Republic. Okay, we're fighting. Okay, here's the deal. I'm not gonna get too stressed out. Fighting is kind of turn-based, kind of not. I mean, I think it is turn-based, but it's less about waiting for your turn, and it kind of all is just going to be happening at once, so the game's on pause right now, and we'll be selecting actions, but a lot of it, too, is just going to be sitting there watching the combat unfold, which is kind of sweet. So, let's go ahead and do it. Press L to continue. Okay, here we go. So if I select attack, they're already attacking me. Yep, so, yeah, you're not actually gonna be, like, having to be good at games to, like, fight, because it's just gonna be more about your stats. Oh, there we go, we already killed our first guy. Trask, what are you doing? Do you have any weapons at all? What? Oh, he's got a blaster, but he decided he wanted to run right up to everybody. What a moron. Okay, we killed our first two people, so we're already murderers, too. Alright, let's keep going. Let's go a little bit farther. Here's another door. I'm sure it's safe on the other side. It's not. Okay, we're paused. Let's use Power Blast. That sounds kind of cool. So I'm going to queue up some actions. You can see I've got this little action bar down here. And when it comes to be my turn, I'll just take the next action in the slot there. So I'm doing a horrible job with Power Blast. Okay, I hope this hasn't been too loud the whole time, but I'm going to turn that down slightly. Okay, remains. So we're already going to loot corpses. What is this, The Witcher? Alright, ooh, that guy has a frag grenade. That's a good deal. We're definitely going to loot everything we can possibly loot. So here's a footlocker. Oh, okay, so two more grenades, a short sword, a long sword, combat suit. Okay, this is a good room. This room is helpful to us. What else do we got here? A metal box. Yeah, you know, they put all the goods in the metal box. Let's see what we got. A med pack and 10 credits. Okay. Look at how this little box opens, too. It's got a little crazy twisting mechanism. I love that. That's so neat. Oops, I'm not sure if I actually looted it. Give me that stuff. Okay, so, let's catch our breath here for a second. I know we're all in panic mode. I don't like how you're kind of in my personal space there, Trask. You're kind of freaking me out, buddy. Alright, we got a couple of things. Also, we can see Trask here, so he's got a blaster pistol. Oops, let's see here, what do I got? So maybe instead of clothing, right, we want to wear the combat suit. Gives us some defense and some dexterity. Wow, very helpful. Yeah, I'm cool using a blaster rifle for a while longer. Let's put some swords on this boy, since he likes to run into combat. So you're gonna have a primary hand and an offhand. The offhand is, you know, imagine in real life, you know, if you're right-handed, you're very dexterous, and then you're left-handed, you're like, I can't even sign my name. So they might give you different weapons for the left hand. We'll use a short sword in the left hand, a long sword in the right hand for Trask. And that means we have his pistol just back in the inventory, so there he is. Oh, whoa! Slow down, buddy. Maybe don't be doing that right next to me. Yeah, that's definitely how I want to remember Trask. What a badass. Okay. I'm going to switch back to my guy. Let's go through one more room here. Now that we're all suited up. Uh-oh. Oh my god, I'm surprised how much sword fighting there is in Star Wars. And these aren't even Jedi, they're just straight up ninjas. Oh my god. These are like stormtroopers, but way cooler somehow. Dude blew up his own guy. Alright, let's get out here. This is too much, this is crazy. Alright, you know what I think that was? I think that was like, hey, you should use grenades. And I will. I'll toss one right in the middle of these guys. Unpause. Grenade. Don't run in there yet, Trask. Oh my god, that guy. No sense of danger. Alright, he's going in for the kill. Get up there. Oh my god, did you see that? He did like a friggin' front flip and took him out. Nice job, buddy. Alright. Yep, well, we got some remains. This is funny. Sometimes if somebody dies for performance, they swap the body out and they just leave this little belt thing, and that signifies the remains. So, Med pack. What else do we got here? Here's some more remains. Credits. You gotta have good credits, you know? More credits in a meta pack. Here's some more remains. More credits. This is good. More money. Another med pack. Okay, I'm not this bad at the game. I don't think you need to be throwing so many med packs at me here. Alright, we got our grenade back. More credits. Yes, this is great. We're getting rich already. We haven't even left the first ship yet. Alright, so I'm pretty sure... Oh, parts pile. Well, it's a good thing I came down this way. Parts. You gotta have parts. Alright, I don't think we're getting through this door. It's definitely seen better days. I think they want us to go through this door. Door. Uh-oh. Do you hear that? I hear lightsabers on the other side of this door. I'm kind of nervous. Let's go through it together next time on the next episode of Let's Peek KOTOR. Goodbye, everybody.